With me is Jahandar Khan. He is from Khyber Pakhtun area of Pakistan. ਤੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਸਿੱਖ ਹੈਰੀਟੇਜ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਰਿਸਰਚ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ. ਹੀ ਇਜ਼ 26 ਈਅਰਸ ਓਲਡ ਐਂਡ ਹੀ ਬਿਲੋਂਗਸ ਟੂ ਵਾਟ ਇਜ਼ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਹਾਓ ਵੀ ਨੋ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਵੈਰੀ ਵੋਲੇਟਾਈਲ ਰੀਜਨ ਆਫ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਨੌਰਥ ਵੈਸਟ ਏਰੀਆ ਵੇਅਰ ਵਿਚ ਬੋਰਡਰਸ ਟੂ ਅਫਗਾਨਿਸਤਾਨ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਟਸ ਵੇਅਰ ਹਰੀ ਸਿੰਘ ਨਲਵਾ ਅੰਡਰ ਮਹਾਰਾਜਾ ਰਣਜੀਤ ਸਿੰਘ played a key role in establishing the Sikh Raj or Sikh Empire, and we want to know from him what kind of interaction that Hari Singh Nalwa have had with the population there. Te us da ki impact hai aaj te pehla ki impact sega. So Jahandar ji, very nice to talk to you.
Thank you very much.
So I just wanted to know ki tell me about yourself and how, where do you belong and how does what is your connection with Hari Singh Nalwa?
Okay, so as you correctly mentioned, I belong to Northwest Pakistan. Northwest Pakistan at one point during the 1800s was part of the Lahore Darbar, and Hari Singh Nalwa was one of the most brave and gallant generals of Maharaja Ranjit Singh, which is
when
why
when you say Lahore Darbar, it is
Maharaja Ranjit Singh.
Okay.
We call it Lahore Darbar in Pakistan, okay. Still for some reason.
Good.
So Maharaja Ranjit Singh sent his bravest and most capable and competent commander to handle this region because it was very volatile then as it is now. My association with Hari Singh Nalwa is that my ancestor, this would be seven generations before me, whose name also was Jahandar Khan, so he would be Jahandar Khan the first and I would be the second. He was a contemporary of Hari Singh Nalwa. And these guys had a complex relationship in which they were enemies at times and friends at times and had alliances. And Hari Singh Nalwa spent about 15 years over there as governor of Hazara. And during these times, there were lots of interaction with the local communities. And I think the point, the key point that we miss out when we study Hari Singh Nalwa is that contemporary literature has only reduced him to just being a strong, yes, brave warrior. Whereas when you travel to these communities in Northwest Pakistan, you will realize that Hari Singh Nalwa was a great administrator as well. He was a great diplomat. He was also a statesman. I think all of these things are qualities of a good statesman. And I think I wouldn't shy away from calling Hari Singh Nalwa a very good statesman. And so in my part of the world, for example, there still is a town called Haripur, which is a big city now. It used to be a town. It's named after Hari Singh Nalwa. And all of the irrigation system over there has been set up by Hari Singh Nalwa, and it's not limited to that. Hari Singh Nalwa introduced standard weights in that part just so trade can be promoted. So
when you say weights, is matlab ki that is the
so standardized system for measuring weights.
Okay,
right. For example, like you have kg. So imagine if everyone was trading between someone was saying pounds and someone was saying kg.
Okay,
it would be really hard to do trade.
Okay.
Right. So he standardized. Trade.
Okay.
Now, I will throw your question back at you and say, when I tell you about all of these things about Hari Singh Nalwa, does that match the profile of the person you know?
No, not at all. Because I always have heard that Hari Singh Nalwa was a warrior, a fighter, and in a way, it gives the impression that he was a ruthless sort of administrator.
Mm-hmm.
He would have controlled this and people would be, you know, dreading from Nalwa. That's how we have been.
But I wouldn't say, you know, Hari Singh Nalwa certainly was a very capable, very competent warrior. There should be no confusion about
this. Of course.
But if I take the example of my own family, now my ancestor Painda Khan, at that point, who was also a contemporary of Hari Singh Nalwa, was one of the most important chiefs in the Khyber region,
yes,
who were resisting,
yes,
Hari Singh Nalwa. And we know from our own sources that Hari Singh Nalwa attempted peace negotiations 6 times with Painda Khan. So before there was war, there was a comprehensive sort of system of peace negotiations. And I think coming back to all of this where we are today, I think our ancestors were far more practical people than we believe.
Absolutely.
We have reduced them to ideological symbols. That's fine. Sometimes we need that. It's important. But I think if you open up history and if you read history from different sources, it emerges that Hari Singh Nalwa and his contemporaries, my own ancestors, were very pragmatic, very practical people, and the things they were doing were the things they needed to survive back in the day.
Yes, yes. So in a way, I'm trying to understand, so what inspires you about this whole period and your sort of connection and, you know, sort of where do you fit in?
When I was growing up back in my village back in Pakistan, someone, they always used to tell me that the home we live in was built by a Sikh.
Achha.
Right? Ki sardaron ne banaya hai. And I always used to be curious growing up that who were these. I've never seen a Sikh in my village. I thought then who's the person who made this house? And back when I was in university, I think is when these questions became more important to me, because at some point in your life, you do want to connect with your roots. And that's where I started reading up about who built that home. And it emerged that there was someone called Hari Singh Nalba who built my own home in Pakistan, okay. Right? The home I grew up in. And then, I just found out, okay, Hari Singh Nalba is not just any guy. He wasn't just someone, who built a home. He was a commander-in-chief of a very big army. And one thing led to another, and my own quest to connect with my own identity. And it's funny because we've limited these things to saying, okay, this is Sikh heritage, this is Muslim heritage, this is that. And I think my journey has taken me across an overlapping quest, where my journey to connect with my own roots has connected me with Hari Singh Nalwa, with Maharaja Ranjit Singh, with the Sikh period over there as well. And I think that's been a big, big motivating sort of factor for me throughout this journey. Mm-hmm.
So one thing which really stands out for me, mere liye badi ek pleasant surprise hai ki Hari Singh Nalwa nu assi ek general de taur te dekhte hain, right? We always see him ki he is a general. Mm-hmm. So I could never imagine he would be caring for nature. Mm-hmm. He would be caring for gardening. Mm-hmm. So tell me about that.
Yeah, sure. So if you or any of your audience has traveled to Pakistan, and if you go to the town of Haripur, the first thing you will notice are the orchards over there.
Okay.
In that town, and this is a system that was entirely introduced. These used to be barren hills that relied on rainfall for agriculture and sporadic rainfall. We're not the most agricultural region of Pakistan. Times were tough. And Hari Singh Nalwa was a visionary who sort of turned some barren hills into orchards, right? And when you go to Haripur today, Harkishangarh Fort is the fort that Hari Singh Nalwa built in Haripur. And if you go around that fort, you will still find the remnants of the comprehensive irrigation system that Hari Singh Nalwa envisioned. We're talking about almost 200 years ago, and had the visionary sense to imagine that. And so a lot of the local agriculture, which is a backbone of industry over there currently, actually the credit goes to Hari Singh Nalwa for all of that. And yes, it does clash with the image of Hari Singh Nalwa as solely being someone who would go in with a sword and beat the hell out of someone and just leave. Because it seems to me that Hari Singh Nalwa had the qualities of a statesman. Mm-hmm. Who could balance power with also understanding the needs of the population. And I think those are lessons we can all learn from today, despite our religious or whatever backgrounds we come from. These are lessons all of us can learn.
Okay, so leading from that, I want to know from you is that we always seen that Islam and Sikhism is a conflict and takra ho raha. So how do you view this? I mean, when you see Hari Singh Nalwa is not promoting the interest of Sikh empire, but promoting the interest of the local people. Mm-hmm. So where do you find these this sort of interaction of Sikhism and Islam and...
To be very honest, I think if Hari Singh Nalwa was to enter a history room today, I think either he would start crying or he would start laughing.
Mm.
Right? Because it's not his fault we have reduced him to something. It's not his fault that we have reduced history to binaries, Islam, Sikh, or good, bad, this, that. History is complex, and we need to appreciate it as being complex. Just to answer sort of your question, I think it's our fault. This is our own, it's our own fault that we've turned history into this. Mm-hmm. In reality, it's quite different.
Yeah. So I mean, you belong to a region where Sikhism really is the birthplace of Sikhism.
Absolutely.
Guru Nanak traveled in that region, established the first communities. Yep. And what would be your message to the Sikh youth growing up in various parts of the world and even in India?
Mm-hmm.
What would be your message?
I think my message would be two things. First is try to understand your history rationally. Because, and this is not just for Sikh youth, this is for youth everywhere.
Uh-huh.
If we try to read history with a bias, great, it gives us a lot of chest thumping, a lot of pride, a lot of glorification, all of those things, but then we reduce our capacity to learn from history.
Mm.
So my message is, if you learn from people like Nalwa, The 1800s were a very complicated time in the world as well. It was all sorts of challenges. We think today is complicated. I mean, it was just as complicated back then. Mm-hmm. And if we don't learn from our role models, right? If we reduce Nalwar to being just a warrior or just one aspect of his personality, I think we limit our own capacity to learn from him. Mm-hmm. Right. So my message to Sikh youth would be to broaden the canvas of history and to look at it from different angles. And I can promise you will find lessons that you can apply to your lives even today, because the world has always been a very complicated place. The other lesson I would say is come to these places, visit these places. There is no substitute to real life interaction.
So if I were to travel with you, where would you take me?
Oh, I would.
हिंदी में बताओ.
देखिए देखिए जी, सबसे बड़ा sort of एक hindrance जो है वो ये है कि जो Sikh community पाकिस्तान आती है तो या उन्हें बताया जाता है या उनका अपना preconceived notion ये होता है कि पाकिस्तान में हमारे लिए important सिर्फ पंजा साहब और ननकाना साहब ही हैं, और वो आते हैं और extended tour करके चले जाते हैं. सबसे पहले तो हमें समझने की ये जरूरत है कि हमारा हेरिटेज बहुत बड़ी एक चीज है, राइट? पाकिस्तान के अंदर सिख हिस्ट्री लेयर्स एंड लेयर्स, इतने लेयर्स हैं कि शायद मैं बता भी ना पाऊं, इतनी ज्यादा रिच हिस्ट्री है. इसमें गुरुद्वारे भी हैं, बहुत हिस्टोरिक गुरुद्वारे भी हैं. इसमें बहुत सारी बैटल फील्ड्स भी हैं, इसमें बहुत सारे फोर्ट्स भी हैं, इसमें बहुत सारे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट्स भी हैं. हम क्यों, जब हम पाकिस्तान आए तो हम क्यों इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ना देखें, हम क्यों ये लेसन ना लेके जाएं कि यार your ancestors were not just fighters, they were also builders. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. They were builders, mm-hmm. Right? वो भी देखना जरूरी है. Artists बहुत सारे थे. आप उनका आर्ट जब आप देखेंगे, आप आर्किटेक्चर देखेंगे, जब आप frescoes देखेंगे कि एक ही फ्रेस्को में हिंदुइज्म भी है, इस्लाम भी है. आई थिंक देर इज अ लॉट टू लर्न फ्रॉम दीज थिंग्स, राइट? सो आई थिंक देर इज, and you know, apart from all of this, there's the broad canvas of Punjabi heritage as well. Achha. Right? Let's not think that's a different thing. That's also part of the same canvas. Punjab mein shrines ka culture hai, tolerance ka culture hai, openness ka culture hai. So I think if I was to bring you to Pakistan, or for you were to come to Pakistan, I would say don't limit yourself just to one or two places. Okay. Broaden your canvas, and I promise you will learn things that you had no idea you would encounter. So positive things.
Okay, so what is the most favorite thing about Hari Singh Nalwa? Mm-hmm. आपको Hari Singh Nalwa की कौन सी ऐसी बात जो बहुत पसंद है?
It's a very personal story. हाँ. But at one point during negotiations with my ancestor Painda Khan, Hari Singh Nalwa said, "I will help you if you give me your son as a hostage." And this son, whose name was also Jahandar Khan, grew up with Hari Singh Nalwa. So he spent 2 or 3 years or maybe 4 years with Hari Singh Nalwa. And during those 4 years, I mean, he was with Hari, they went to Lahore together, they were at Haripur together.
So the son
of the enemy,
achha,
growing up with Hari Singh Nalwa.
And usko Sikh nahi banaya.
Usko Sikh nahi banaya, bilkul nahi banaya. Let's fast forward now, 15 saal baad, wohi ladka, 1846 mein, 1846 में 26 साल उसकी उम्र है, और न्यूज पहुंच गई हजारा के सिखों को डिफीट हो गई अंग्रेजों से, एंड एवरीवेयर यू गो पीपल आर अटैकिंग द सिख गैरिसंस एंड मैसेकरिंग देम. दिस यंग बॉय जहानदार खान वाज द लीडर ऑफ हिज ट्राइब, द तनोली ट्राइब बाय दिस टाइम, एंड द 26 ईयर ओल्ड ऑर्डर्ड दैट नन ऑफ द 22 सिख ऑफ ऑल ऑफ द सिख गैरिसंस इन आवर रीजन, इन आवर पार्ट ऑफ खैबर पख्तूनख्वा, दे शुड बी गिवन अ डिग्निफाइड एग्जिट. So if he was mistreated as a kid, would he have done that? Not at all. I think he learned a lot of kindness, and I think it left a positive impression on him. And I think, to answer your original question, what sort of person would be so kind to the son of his enemy? Is a question we should all think about.
Absolutely, absolutely. और जो मैं last question आपसे ये पूछना चाहता हूँ कि इंडिया पाकिस्तान की आज conflict की बात की जाती है, वर्ल्ड वाइड ये कहा जाता है कि 3 मोस्ट वॉलेटाइल रीजन है, नॉर्थ कोरिया है, इंडिया पाकिस्तान और मिडल ईस्ट है.
जी, ऐसे.
और वो जगह जहां पे जिसकी बात हम कर रहे हैं, खास करके खैबर पख्तून एरिया जहां पे अब्दाली आता है और सारे इन्वेडर्स आते हैं, Hari Singh Nalwa का क्या रोल है जिससे आज इंटरनेशनल कम्युनिटी एक लेसन ले सकती है, साउथ एशियन रीजन में कोई नया पैगाम दिया जा सकता है?
देखिए जी, मेरा तो ख्याल ये है कि Hari Singh Nalwa अगर तो मिलिटरीली किसी को सबड्यू करना चाहते थे तो सिख सरकार इतनी पावरफुल थी कि वो लाहौर में बैठते, अपनी जिंदगी एंजॉय करते, अपने खेतों में रहते और किसी को भेज देते कि यार जो उधर लड़ाई झगड़े कर रहे हैं आप जाके उन्हें, यू नो, जस्ट गेट डन विद इट एंड क्रश द मूवमेंट. But he chose to spend 15 years in the area. He chose to understand the people. He chose to understand the customs, the people, the area, their faith, what they like, what they don't. And I think a large part of jo aajkal puri duniya mein bhi aur you know South Asia mein bhi masle hain, hum ek dusre ko samajhne ki koshish nahi karte. Hum judgments pass karte hain ekdam. अगर मेरे ख्याल में हरी सिंह नलवा जिंदा होते हैं तो वो सबसे पहले जाके इश्यूज को खुद समझने की कोशिश करते हैं बाय इंटरैक्टिंग विद द कम्युनिटीज नॉट बाय सिटिंग बिहाइंड द टीवी एंड ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड सो देयर इज नो सब्स्टिट्यूट फॉर रियल लाइफ इंटरैक्शन आई थिंक टू मेक द वर्ल्ड अ बेटर प्लेस वी नीड टू मीट ईच अदर मोर राइट एंड द पीपल टू पीपल थिंग नीड्स टू हैपन एंड आई थिंक दैट्स द लेसन आई टेक फ्रॉम हरी सिंह नलवा एज वेल 15 इयर्स ही स्पेंट इन दैट रीजन he could have spent you know he I'm sure he had better places to do to go and better things to do
yes,
as well
yes. and many times people of your age too, you're 26 year old and younger think that our history is boring what do we learn from history is the same thing old stuff so what would how should one read history that they feel the same kind of passion that you have and they feel inspired
I think it's not history that's boring. It's how we're telling the story.
Ah, okay.
Right? So we understand marketing. We're in a world where marketing is a thing today.
Yes.
Right? People make careers out of marketing. And so I think history needs to learn something as well. The field of history as a whole. If we confine this to academics, if we confine this
or
to
dates or
just dates or just sitting down and you know the same kind of thing going again, I think that we won't see a lot of interest.
Yeah.
I think for young people to take this up, I think it needs to be made cool.
Yes.
I think they need to find it relatable.
Yes.
Right? It shouldn't be that this is what someone 200 years ago did. Yes. It should be this is what someone did and you know what he did is the kind of situation you're facing today as well. And
How can it be applicable? Yeah.
But the storytelling part is key.
Yeah.
You need to use digital technology. You need to use all the tools at your hand for marketing. To make it appealing and to make it cool. Because if you don't do it, I mean young people, I mean today they just go after what's cool and what's interesting. And that's the obstacle that needs to be overcome.
So in Punjab, especially in Punjab, the youth is, they feel, you know, kind of a big section of Sikh youth feel lost. Because we had a very difficult period in
absolutely.
The 30 years.
Absolutely.
So there is a malaise and there is a you know, kind of despair, inspiration, you know, everything is seen very negatively. So this provides a kind of different, totally different perspective. What would be, if you had a young Sikh brother, what would be your message to him?
I think my message to him would be that today, let's remember, for the longest time, history was something that was tightly controlled always.
Yes.
Today, we have more tools at our disposal,
not
just to understand history, but to connect with each other as well, than any previous generation did before. Yes, times have been tough. Yes, the world can at times look like a cruel place, but also the opportunities today are opportunities that no previous generation can have. And let's also think that maybe the solutions to today's problems are solutions that we ourselves create today.
Yes.
Let's be bold enough to imagine that we need to come up with new solutions today.
Yes.
Right? So don't be worried. Use the tools at your disposal. Connect with people. I think ultimately everything is about people. So use the tools you have at your disposal to connect with people and use that to your advantage.
Yeah. So aapke jo jo pichle jo फैमिली जो ट्री है और जो भी लोग हैं उन्होंने भी बहुत कुछ सफर किया
ऐसे ही
बहुत वहां पे डिफिकल्ट पीरियड्स में भी उन्होंने अपने आप को बचा के रखा और ये सिचुएशन में मैंने हर डिफिकल्ट जो दुरानी आया मुगल आए ब्रिटिश आए सिख आए तो इन सब से जो इस पीरियड की बात जब करते हैं आपके बुजुर्ग तो उनके जो बयानों में सिख पीरियड को कैसे देखा जाता है
देखिए जी सिख पीरियड को पहली बात तो ये कि सिख पीरियड हमारा पहला इंटरेक्शन था विद सम ऑर्गेनाइज्ड फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट
ओके
राइट इससे पहले दुरानी एरा था या मुगल एरा था दैट वाज मोर यस इट माइट हैव रिप्रेजेंटेड अ सेंट्रलाइज्ड सिस्टम इन दिल्ली बट इन द माउंटेन्स ऑफ नॉर्थ वेस्ट पाकिस्तान द ट्राइबल सिस्टम स्टिल कंटिन्यूड और प्रीटी मच यही समझा जाता था कि जिसकी लाठी उसकी भैंस हमारा इनके साथ कोई सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट नहीं है सिख पीरियड में पहली दफा एक सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट का सिस्टम आया कि देयर हमारी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज हैं कुछ हमारे राइट्स हैं जो लोग क्लेम कर रहे हैं कि वो हमें हमारे ऊपर रूल करना चाहते हैं, कुछ हमारी एक्सपेक्टेशंस होनी चाहिए इन लोगों से. वी नीड टू डिमांड बेटर लाइफ, वी नीड टू डिमांड बेटर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंग. तो सिख पीरियड में डेफिनेटली फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम ट्राइबलिज्म से स्टेटक्राफ्ट की तरफ एक थिंकिंग आपको नजर आती है. और जब आप बुजुर्गों से भी बात करेंगे तो ये चीज आपको मैनिफेस्ट होगी कि दिस वॉज आर फर्स्ट एक्सपीरियंस विद ऑर्गेनाइज्ड फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. क्रुएल्टी की जहां बात है, देन yes, at the Mughal time we had experienced the worst kinds of, you know, cruelty and all of those things. But I think there is a vocabulary issue as well. जब हम Sikh period कहते हैं तो हमें अक्सर ऐसा लगता है कि सिखों ने आके सिर्फ सिखों ने आके वहां हुकूमत की है. महाराजा रंजीत सिंह में की फौज में आधा से ज्यादा तो लोग मुसलमान थे. हमारे एरिया में जब आते थे हरि सिंह नलवा आते थे या बाकी सिख कमांडर्स आते थे तो उनके साथ मुस्लिम ट्रूप्स होते थे सारे के सारे, right? There were so many incidences in which artillery man जो था उनका इलाही बख्श जिनका नाम था उनके साथ मुस्लिम कंटिजेंट आता था. तो आई थिंक इसको इस तरह भी नहीं देखना चाहिए कि वो सिर्फ एक सिख पीरियड था और मुस्लिम्स के ऊपर रूल हो रहा था. इट वॉज फार मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड एंड आई थिंक दैट्स हाउ वी कम टू व्यू इट एज वेल. एंड आई थिंक देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ मिसकंसेप्शंस दैट एग्जिस्ट. बट यहाँ मेरे जैसे यूथ का रोल आता है. I see myself as a citizen of the 21st century. I have many Sikh friends like you do. I have many friends all over the world like you do. So what is the role I play? अगर कोई गलत history, अगर कोई history को इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं मेरी community में to promote hatred towards someone, then it's my responsibility to create a better alternative, a better narrative, because the world doesn't need more negativity.
Yeah. और last question मैं पूछना चाहता हूँ कि आपके region में सिखों के बारे में क्या impression? आम कल्चर में, पॉप कल्चर में क्या है इंप्रेशन? क्योंकि आपने एक एक मुझे बताया था कि आम लोग क्या कहें.
ऐसा ही है. मैं रिसेंटली एक हेरिटेज एंड फोकलोर मैनेजमेंट पे एक वर्कशॉप में ले रहा था जिसपे किसी ने पूछा, जो इंस्ट्रक्टर थे उन्होंने कहा, व्हाट डू यू नो अबाउट सिखिज्म? तो लोगों ने अपने हाथ उठाए.
ये पाकिस्तान
में इस्लामाबाद में हो रहे थे. कुछ लोगों ने कहा हमें नहीं पता, हमें यू नो वी वुड लाइक टू नो मोर. तो जितने लोग केपी के थे लड़के, उन्होंने अपने हाथ उठाए और उन्होंने एक ही बात बोली जो मुझे काफी इंटरेस्टिंग लगी, बिकॉज जब तीन चार लोग एक बात बोलते हैं तो इट्स नॉट जस्ट अ कोइंसिडेंस. उन्होंने ये कहा कि हम बचपन में जब मैं बाजार जाया करता था सौदा लेने के लिए अपनी वालदा के साथ, अपनी अम्मी के साथ, तो अम्मी हमेशा ये कहती थी कि सरदारों की दुकान से लो, ये झूठ नहीं बोलेंगे, ये ऑनेस्ट लोग हैं. और ये तीन चार लोग उस जगह बैठे हुए थे जिन्होंने सबने ये ही बात की, राइट? आई थिंक दैट इज एन एक्सेलेंट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ प्रेसिडेंट दैट अ सिख कम्युनिटी हैज सेट.
That is branding. सो ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਗੁਣ ਨੇ ਡਿਪਲੋਮੇਸੀ ਦੇ, ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਇੰਟਰੈਕਟ ਕਰਨ ਦੇ, ਪਿਆਰ ਪਾਉਣ ਦੇ, ਨੇਚਰ ਪ੍ਰੀਜ਼ਰਵ ਕਰਨ ਦੇ, ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਇਹੋ ਜਿਹੇ ਵਧੀਆ ਵਧੀਆ ਗੁਣ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਨਾਲ ਭਰਪੂਰ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਸ਼ਖਸੀਅਤ ਹੈ ਹਰੀ ਸਿੰਘ ਨਲਵਾ, ਉਹਦੇ ਤੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਕੁਛ ਸਿੱਖ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ. ਸੋ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਧੰਨਵਾਦ.
ਬਹੁਤ ਸ਼ੁਕਰੀਆ.
ਤੁਸੀਂ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਚ ਜਰਾ ਇੱਕ ਥੋੜਾ ਜਿਹਾ ਫਿਕਰਾ ਦੱਸ ਦਿਓ ਸਾਰੇ.
ਬੜੀ ਬੜਾ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਕੀਤਾ ਥਾ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਸੋ ਮੈਂ ਐਕਸਪੈਕਟ ਨਾ ਕਰਦਾ ਸਾ ਇਤਨਾ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਬੜਾ ਇੱਕ ਪੋਜ਼ਿਟਿਵ ਰਿਸਪਾਂਸ ਮਿਲ ਸੀ. ਮੇਰੀ ਤਾਂ ਖੁਆਇਸ਼ ਹੈ ਹੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਮੈਂ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਰਹਿੰਦਾ ਔਰ ਕਦੇ ਵੀ ਮੈਂ ਕੋਈ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰਾ ਵਿਜ਼ਿਟ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀਤਾ.
ਅੱਛਾ.
ਤੇ ਕਾਫੀ ਆਇਰਨੀ ਹੈ ਇਸ ਗੱਲ 'ਚ ਕਿ ਮੈਂ 12,000 ਮੀਲ ਦੂਰ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਆ ਕੇ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਦਫ਼ਾ ਸਿੱਖ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਨਾਲ ਇੰਟਰੈਕਟ ਕੀਤਾ. ਤੇ ਬਿਲਕੁਲ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਡਾਇਲੈਕਟ ਅਸੀਂ ਬੋਲਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਦਾ, ਇਸਕੋ ਹਿਲਕੋ ਆਖਿਆ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ. ਇਹ ਨੌਰਥ ਵੈਸਟਰਨ ਡਾਇਲੈਕਟ ਹੈ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਦਾ. ਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਵੀ ਇਸੀ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਦਾ ਹਿੱਸਾ. ਤੇ ਬਿਲਕੁਲ ਇੱਕ ਬਹੁਤ ਅੱਛੀ ਯਾਦਾਂ ਕਹਿ ਕੇ ਵਾਪਸ ਚੁਲਸਾ ਵਾਪਸ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ.
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ. ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਧੰਨਵਾਦ ਜੀ. ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਸੋ ਮਚ. ਐਂਡ ਵੀ ਵਿਲ ਕੰਟੀਨਿਊ ਦਿਸ ਕਾਈਂਡ ਆਫ ਡਿਸਕਸ਼ਨ ਅਗੇਨ.